I'll be at the school every day. I didn't get your email until after I got home.
That's fine. You can open meeting at 7:06. So I thought maybe we would just start with numbers as far as registrations are concerned. So between what we have online, between what Celia just handed me, and you said there were a few, and I have a few at home that need to be entered, that's a total of 58.
I think we're into 64.
Right, so keep in mind, you've not registered. I'm not registered. One.
I'm not registered.
So, and I'm not registered, so there's an addition, and...
So there's 70 between us.
So it's around 65 or 66.
And then there was another, I don't know.
Did Dan sign up yet? Did he sign up yet?
Yeah, he did online.
And then,
That's good, we still have 1 month ago.
Or, we have 2 weeks.
2 weeks. June 15th, right now.
The last day of school for the kids.
And you had a girl.
She was a partial withdrawal, is that right?
She's a partial withdrawal, that's what I wanted to ask you before I said refunded it.
Okay.
Unless she's going to get it.
No.
Okay.
No, because I hadn't
so
responded.
So 58 total registrations, not including committee members, who have not registered.
Did Blake register yet?
I haven't seen Blake.
Yeah, she was going to drop it off at my house.
She did paper?
I think so.
Oh, well, that's fine.
But she did it on the line.
No.
Well,
that's okay, so let's just say 70.
Go ahead, 70.
We'll say party 70.
And what was last year's number? 70?
78.
78.
Oh, 75.
So 78.
And there was always that, there was that last week, there was like a whole bunch.
Mm-hmm.
And if we, and the nice thing about the online, is that you can just keep the online open till the week before, and they can still register online, but they can't register by paper any longer, because they can do payment plans and everything else through the online version if you want. So, and then we don't have to get the money, it's all through the credit card system, it goes right to our bank account, so I don't know if you just want to keep that open. Right now we're ahead, so, right?
Yeah, so we have
yeah.
9 counselors for Raleigh, and then just Katie, the team, right now.
So we're all having counselors?
We have a higher one.
Which really is 5 kids, right?
Right.
And I was going to tell you before the meeting start, the teen camp, I don't know. I need to dig deep into what weeks are actually going on. I don't know if they're a full 7 weeks or not. So I need to look at that.
So I've been going before the select board with grants, and this did come up. They would like to know, it was asked of me, what is the threshold for the teen camp to run? When do we decide to combine weeks if we don't get enough kids? Do we eliminate weeks? How do we determine how to scale back the teen camp if we don't get enough participants to cover the costs?
Don't know.
I think when that conversation came up, it was also looking at the time frame. How much time do we need, lead time do we need to give families? That was my impression.
Well, I think it has to take
Sam had said that that there was one parent who signed her kid up for Camp Raleigh because it was 5 days a week, but had teen camp been 5 days a week, or she had the option of doing teen camp and Camp Raleigh together, she would have signed up both of her kids because she signed up an older child. It was one of the traditions.
Yeah.
I think it was just one parent.
It was one parent, but she has two kids. And she signed one up for teen camp and one up for Camp Raleigh.
And I did, there was one on Facebook too that asked if it was 5 days a week. There are people asking if it is a 5 day a week thing. I'm saying no, it's a 3 day a week thing. And I think, because they can get the same cost that summer's worth for 5 days a week.
Alright, so let me just ask a question. So if we've got teen camp. Now, the tuition for that, is it cover the t-shirt and the transportation? Is that how you we had designed it? The t-shirt and transportation. And the
pretty much covers everything. And the, and actually it covered the pay for a director as well as an assistant director.
Yeah.
So that tuition per week covered. So
but how many students was it to break it even?
15.
Yeah. 15 students per week to break even with those expenses.
Yeah.
And how many do you have now?
5.
So we don't even have that.
But we're getting 2 from you.
Yeah, for a couple of weeks, but that I'm not doing the full summer.
I have 3 registered.
And if you scale back the weeks, you don't have the transportation costs.
Yeah,
and
I know
once your
kids
like that.
Right.
You know
how
to sign up the same
way
kids are going.
Durham.
And what Sam said, she's going to sign up for
bus services that they're the only ones with the small bus. No, Durham. The name is Durham Bus Services. And I see them picking up kids all day, all year long, but I have no idea how to get in touch with them. They're the only ones with a 15 passenger bus.
So I brought that up to the select board too about that Kelly had mentioned. If we could get a grant for transportation, that would be wonderful. But a lot of companies don't want to give direct costs that we should be covering. And so they suggested check with C&J, because C&J in the past has offered the select board a driver and a small bus to do tours around town for different issues.
Do they even have a small bus anymore?
They have like a minivan driver. I've seen minivans with their emblem on it and stuff. I don't know, but I don't know if that's like.
So what
now that we have a select board member here, you know, how, if we have a small group, is it more affordable to say rent a car for 3 days and let the director drive to that? Like, how could we, you know,
you have to be 18 or 21 to rent a car. You say you can't have your director renting a
car.
Oh,
our director's 33 years old.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I'm director. She's director of team.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But she's, how old are you? Oh, 20-something?
Yeah, 20-something.
Yes, I'm 22. Okay.
All right. But how many will a car fit? I mean, depending if you're talking van.
Right.
I guess a van, possibly, but.
I don't know what the I mean, I think we've always talked about liability and who. You know, because, like, I've said, too, I own a 15-passenger van. Like, could I lease my van to the town for $1?
So, I guess the first thing I would be thinking of is insurance. And
I mean, you would have to have the same standard as what they would have at a school field trip. If a parent drives in school, you know, whatever their requirement is. 100, 500, or whatever, you know what I'm talking about. You would at least have to make that, but I'm going to write this down.
Because right now, with our teen camp, we have
$500
a week for our 2, correct?
When we checked this out last year, our insurance was not going to cover renting a vehicle and having a director drive it, because they don't have the insurance. And Caroline can explain that more because she deals with Primax. And I don't have access to those emails any longer.
Right. But why wouldn't?
Yeah, that, I would assume that we wouldn't be the coverage. It would have to be whoever is the driver would have to have that coverage.
But that's not, the Primex would not cover, it's a town thing, so Primex would not cover us.
That's correct.
Yeah.
That's what I'm agreeing with you. You know, it would be totally on whoever's the driver, their insurance, which I don't think you'd want to do, to be honest with you. I mean.
Sign a waiver.
Because that was my thought, just go to Enterprise and get a 15 passenger van.
Right, right.
Yeah, for the day. Which would have been way cheaper, but that wasn't going to happen. So that's why I thought Durham Services, because they do have 15 passenger buses. But I don't know how to get in touch with them. I see them drive all over town, but.
What is it?
They're called Durham Services.
Now, the one that does the school, they don't have a 15 passenger bus?
No.
First
student.
And I reworked your numbers just because I had to have them for a grant. And I'm not sure I got it exactly right, but I only counted buses for 2 days because I figured they're going with Camp Raleigh to the pool.
Right, yes. But 2 full days is like 250 a day. So it's like 500 for, so I think we counted 3,500 was our transportation if I'm.
Christopher just got picked up in one of those first student buses that's like a third of the size. Have you seen that? Did you see that at all at the school? I couldn't believe it. It was
well,
the
size
of the bus. I wonder if there's.
Well, when I sent the info to first student, I said.
Is it like one of those short buses? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, look, so if you look at it from the front, it looks like a regular bus. You would never know until you get to look into the side of it, and it's like a third, literally a third of the size of it.
Yeah, so when I sent all the info to first student, I asked for the smaller buses for the team camp.
Mm-hmm.
It would still be the same price as a full size bus, however.
They're expensive,
so,
the driver. Mostly the driver and the insurance part, I would assume.
Okay, one quick side note. There, we have a walking
permission
waiver form that's on the drive, which I don't think you have gotten on. So I will send it to the rec directors at Camp Raleigh and just put it on my to-do list so that when you send the letters out, camp parents and you're sending waivers, slip that in there so that they can sign off their kids walking back and forth to team camp.
Did you check to see if you could find that?
Durham Services?
Yeah.
I'm trying to look right now.
Okay, and then we thought maybe some, I don't think it would hurt for us to check with C&J.
Well, and I guess if we tell them we're paying, right?
So, can I have you go back to. We started with numbers, D. And we're circling back. Of the 58 registered, 5, you said, or less, were teen camp, only were teen camp?
There was 3 that I had.
And
I don't know, the school, I don't know if the school had any.
The, one of the ones I gave you was teen camp.
So before the
4.
Yeah, before.
And then, do we know how many of them are all 8 weeks?
No, I'm just, no. I don't know yet. It's hard, even if I look at this, it's hard to tell. You can't, the bummer about this reporting through Sports Engine is that you can't say, okay, who's on the first week? You can't just break it down like that. It's this is what you get. You get a whole lot
like
of
like, it gives you the dates and everything. I'm like, I don't know what week that is.
Yeah, it's like you just give
you
a whole, so you have to go through and try and figure it out.
I haven't been on in a while,
mm-hmm.
but you should be able to run a report. I want who's coming July 22nd or whatever.
Okay, if you know how to do that, let me know because I tried everything to try to figure
that
out. Like, it can't be that hard. It has to be.
They said that you could run a report on everything. So,
I mean, there's a lot of field options to sort it by.
Yeah. So I've been on the phone with them and I have free time this week.
Because I know at the last meeting you said there were 18 of the 33 registered for all 8 weeks.
So you want to break down the.
Yeah.
No, I can tell you.
I don't
and by fall.
And we've gone up 35.
Yeah, because all I could drill down to was this much.
Okay.
And that's it.
And
so I just went through and counted up how many.
And I haven't been on in a while. As they're coming in, are you putting them into the right age group?
I haven't been on in a couple of days.
Okay.
So I haven't been. But I know how to, so I can. I just haven't done it yet.
Okay, so it's
has a 6-passenger SUV. They can always call Don and see if he can get an idea. Better than 250.
So what are
right. So, and they have the insurance, and it's their liability. So that covers us. But at the time when we were looking at the 35-passenger bus. And
Do you have numbers for pre and post?
I do. So that's the good news. I know we're skipping around, and I kind of don't want to do that. But let's bring it back to numbers for a minute. So the pre and post, the numbers are high, and I think it's because it was the pre and post times were, I think, a good selling point for us. But I think we definitely did the right thing by offering that and sending that for sure. So the first week is, we've got 20 coming for pre-care.
Wow.
We got big numbers there.
22.
22.
Just for week one?
Yeah. I can give you this if you want. You don't have to write it down. And make it easier.
Just add two to all that.
Well, and then there's Zoe and Gavin who are going to be
really
on and off and on and off.
Yeah,
and
but that's
off.
Your
okay.
issue, not mine. They're there when you're there. That's you.
So we've got, I'll just add two of the numbers. So
yeah.
Pre is 20 for the first week. Post is 12.
So 14. Are they doing post too?
She added in two.
Oh, you added in two.
Okay. They're doing post, right?
Go ahead.
So the second week is 15 pre. I'm sorry, 17 pre. And 9 post. The third week is 23 pre.
Wow.
12 post. Fourth week, 19 pre, 11 post. Week of the 23rd, 20 pre, 13 post. Week of the 30th is 21 pre, 13 post. Week of the 6th, 21 pre, 10 post. Week of the 13th, 23 pre, and 11 post.
Are we capping that at anywhere, or are we?
We were capping it at 16. We were, but I think we're fine. We've got enough staff, right, to cover the morning shifts.
Well, I mean, yes. I don't know. Because originally it was just going to be one counselor if you were capping it at 16.
Mm-hmm.
But these are all
We have the ability to flex around.
No, we do. Okay. I'm just wondering, is that?
Well, last year you had 3 people, and not all 3 needed to sit at the desk.
Right, and we were changing it
this
year. But if we go back to that, is that an issue?
What about the assistant, the director of team camp?
That's what I was
going
to say.
She's only going to be there 3 days a week. So I'm thinking more Tuesdays and Thursdays.
And she doesn't start till 9.
Yeah.
No, that's what she could cover. She could come in at 7:30.
Oh, can she? We built in extra hours.
No, physically can't because she knows that that's an option.
Well, I know
yes.
Oh, okay. So that, I mean, I haven't said to her, like, hey, you're going to do this, but.
Is it cheaper to have a counselor come in?
Probably. Yes.
Yeah.
That is to be yes.
So like on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
And
or all week.
It would maybe be more consistent for the counselor if they worked 1 week all starting. 7:30 or whatever.
We can always switch up to like 1 week.
Yeah.
And worst case scenario, if you're short that next morning, just call me and I can get Zoe back there. Then I can open them. Well, I can sit there until you come with a key.
So it is post is still lower than pre though, huh? Even with the 5:30.
And still, post is less expensive too.
Right.
$5 less.
Yeah, it's still more than last year, I think.
More
yeah,
people?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. At post
not
or both?
There, no.
At post, yeah. Yeah, they were usually the last thing picked up. All
right, so I think I'm done with my numbers.
You too?
I don't have any financial numbers
okay.
right now.
Or maybe. Yeah.
not that I'm not concerned
that
about it.
Let's see how that works.
All right, so we can close that part off. So I just want to make sure we go back to the teen camp. So you want to call C&J, you want to call, you have...
I'll call Feliciano, see if they can do, the SUV will hold 6 passengers and a driver, their driver. So...
And is that all that
and
they
then
have?
And
they have the 6 and the 35?
No, they have a whole bunch. They
okay.
have the 6, but then the next one goes to a limo, a 9-person limo.
So they're
going to
be
traveling
that.
In comfort if it's under 250
a day.
Yeah. Anything under 250 a day is better than what we're going to
mm-hmm.
be paying for this giant bus that is going to be empty.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So, and still, I think you're still going to get, you probably will get more because parents are starting to like, what do I do with my kid now? Because they're all like me going, oh, the school's ending in 2 weeks. Oops.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I used to talk about field trips for them. I haven't called a couple back confirming due to prices and the number of kids that we have. I don't know if going with their group rates is really going to be the cheapest option if we stay this small.
And they won't give us a group rate if you only have 5
right.
anyway.
No.
Right.
So. But
we
that goes into contingency.
Yeah,
so
we're going to have to just, yeah.
At least we've got a line of contingency in.
So am I still booking a group rate then? Like saying that we have 20 or 25 kids even though we have like 5?
No.
Whatever's
no.
cheaper.
No,
cheaper.
So.
I wouldn't.
Create your tickets and stuff or something?
Yeah.
You know what I just did here on the radio? Blitz is having a sale right now. of jump any amount of time all summer. $60.
Are there tramp camps though? Is that tramp camp?
I don't think it's
okay.
called anything. I just, and I think we have purchasing.
Yeah, it's just like open gym kind
of. Right.
Yeah.
And
so.
Is that like per person?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't know. That
How
might
many times
be.
Did you guys add in something? I don't have a schedule.
I think we only have it once, but if there's
but if
rain
have,
stuff,
mm-hmm.
that would be, if we had those passes, that would be
yeah,
definitely an option.
Mm-hmm. And what did I do? I think I added it into one of our grants.
Oh, nice.
I don't know
how
okay.
in the world that you are keeping track of all these grants. I really don't know.
I see an email and I just grant folders.
They're driving around. I want
to
like
we
just
would
pull
like
them
to
over.
$500
for doping camp. These funds will allow campers to spend more time at venues like this.
The local
trampoline park that has a high venue cost. Oh, then I figured if we can get $500, that could buy a couple of kids an extra hour.
Yeah.
Well,
what was it?
So
what was the regular price? It was $20 for
an hour.
It's $17 an hour.
Yeah.
And $3 for your socks.
So it almost seems like, I don't know.
So what? I can call and
to
talk to them about it. Just have to call them back anyway.
Yeah.
But then, on the days that they're off, the parents can give them little passes and drop them off at Blitz.
Uh-huh. But I was thinking that we would buy them and just keep a whole, you know what I mean? Keep them in. Do you have to keep a name to those? Or can you just like?
I think they're in the system.
Yeah.
Like when you show up, you're in the system.
So we couldn't, that's what I'm saying is like 1 week you could give them to the 5 kids that are there. The next week we can give them to the other 5 that are there. As a rotating
that,
pass. That
like,
might be a good question. Right?
Can we
rotate the passes?
The winter ones they had, it was like you had like a swipe card, but when you scanned it in, it was like a picture of the child, and then...
But maybe if we ask them what we're trying to do, that's a lot, $17 an hour.
Yeah, for just an hour.
I think the picture that you sent us all, I found it on the drive, said you had budgeted $20 for Blitz Air Park. So that would be one.
Well, I think that's why it was probably a group rate, I think,
mm-hmm.
was what it was.
Yep. And even I was looking for the grants, and even Canopy Lake and Funtown Splashdown, you have to have 25 to get your group rate, and you have to have 25 to get in a chaperone, one free chaperone for 10 people. And if you don't have the 25, you don't get the group chaperone free, so then the chaperone has to pay.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a tough year.
So I guess we have to decide now. Do you keep going on with the teen camp at such a low number, or do you take that money and put them in trends or put them in the works or put them in something else where they can go, because these parents are counting on something.
Wait, do you mean us put them in trends, or
yeah,
letting the parents know that we're no longer offering teen camp and have them and just refund them in?
Because that, you personally, I feel an obligation to cover the cost of wherever they're going to go. Which,
well, we can't make that decision for them. I mean, for the parents either.
Right, you can't say, "Oh, your kid's going to go here now." I think the only we can do is if we need to cancel it, we just say we'll refund you at full price, and we're sorry. But.
So, at what threshold are we? Because I think that's what the select board asked, right? That was their specific question.
I don't know. I personally feel like we get a, I don't know. We got to wait till the 15th, don't you think?
Well, that was one of my other questions, is can we get it out on Facebook this week and do like a countdown on our Facebook or our...
It's been on Facebook, and it's been sponsored and pushed on every feed. Mm-hmm. Within a 30-mile radius.
And like you said, we've got people coming in from Lebanon.
We've come people from Lebanon, from Dover, from Sanford, from Summersworth.
Can I post it on like my personal page?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I have on mine.
Yeah.
But I was thinking, like, even on our Camp Raleigh page, 10 more days to register, 5 more days to register, doing like a countdown like that, so that people know the deadline is coming, and maybe that'll drive up registrations if people see it.
But then that has to be a sponsored thing, because the only people you're going to hit are the 120 that already like our page. So you got to sponsor it and push it.
You might want to notify at least the people who have signed up that you haven't got your numbers, and it's potentially might have to be canceled,
right,
because of it.
Because the other slots at the other camps will get full. And that's not fair to them.
Right.
Because those camps will close at the same time.
Yeah.
And that will give them their choice whether they want to hold out or get refunded.
Yeah, I'm almost wondering if the 15th is even too late to start doing that.
I think it is.
Yeah.
I mean, that's last day of the sponsor, right? It's
15th.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I think you need to at least forewarn them, like, now. You know, give them the option to either hold out or get refunded back, because you have a lot of numbers you still have to get in order to have, or what you projected to have. I'm not sure you're going to make it.
Oh yeah, I don't think we're going to make it. But the money is budgeted, and when it's not set off by revenue, the town will have to raise that amount anyway, whether we use it or not, and then they have that money. And it can either go back in the general fund or whatever. So we have the money to do what we need to do with the 5 kids that we have.
What if we scale it back and use, look at, if D, say this week, you look at the numbers, and if Kelly registers her kids, which will possibly bring in a couple more.
People have asked me what weeks you're going. So
or if you can talk to those people and say, "I'm going to register for this week," and coordinate with D, then we can look at the weeks that we are close to getting there and let the parents know we are consolidating down to maybe 4 weeks that are our top getters, and you need to look at other options for the other weeks.
Well, that's why it might be interesting just to see what those, maybe Dee, we can talk about that if you can, or like what weeks did those kids sign up for?
Okay.
Why don't we have that as a discussion, and then
Because I know the one that I looked at, the one teen camp signed up for 5 weeks. And it was weeks 1 through 3, and I think it was 5, 6.
Was that an in-town person?
Yes, it was.
Oh, that's nice.
And the sibling, this was the family Roxanne was talking about,
yeah,
and
yeah,
the sibling is signed up for all 8 weeks at Camp Raleigh.
Okay.
So,
that was it, there was no free camp.
But now we've opened that up, if they can have the camp schedule, the director's available to hang with them.
When did I miss that?
We discussed it, didn't we? Maybe not. That was my impression.
Because somebody asked the other night, and I had no answer for them till tonight's meeting.
Did we discuss that at a meeting, that the director of the teen camp could
kind
of with those kids?
Yeah. Are you talking to me? Because I wasn't sure about the
so what on Facebook?
Numbers for the regular post and pre, like if it was gonna
cover that were on Facebook, yes.
Yes, the couple of kids we saw. So we talked about
that
saying with those couple.
Yeah, and that's where I thought someone was backing out.
So Jody, she was saying that, yeah, we did discuss it at one of our meetings.
About her hanging out with her kids, depending on the number of our kids. So it wasn't mushing, depending on staff and kid numbers.
So if anybody asks, yes, we offer pre and post for teen care. They can watch the little ones.
It's easier if they only need post.
Yeah.
But.
Well, maybe that's what, I don't know, only available for post-care.
I guess in that case, they could just hang out with us because we're already going to need at least one other counselor saying.
It's just kind of funny that we're worried about numbers, but now we're looking
for
post-care. So I don't know.
But I'm thinking if we offer pre and post-care, it might draw in more people. Like we said, we had somebody from Dover who wanted to sign up their kid, but was asking about pre and post care for their teenager because they don't live within walking distance, so they don't have a ride. So I would say that we put that out there, that teen camp has pre and post, or at least post care available.
Okay,
I make a motion that teen camp offers pre and post care.
I need a second. Are we going pre and post?
It's just post, right?
Just post would be preferred.
Because of our numbers?
Yes, because of our numbers.
How many counselors is it per kid?
Mm-hmm.
How many kids is it per counselor?
That's in the age range, but I've been kind of blending them and saying 1 to 9. Because it's supposed to be 1 to 8 for first to second, and then 1 to 10 for everybody else. So.
And for the teen camp, it's 1 to 10, so she could get up to 10 kids and hang out with them in the ratio. So Dee seconded based just on post care. Did we take a vote?
All in favor?
Aye.
Any nays?
No.
Okay.
One nay.
Then that's a fail for both. Because then it's just harder to work. They're already confused. We're already getting calls. I can't fill out my form. Go online. It's easier.
So if we made it full, would you be willing to go for it? For teen camp, pre and post?
Yeah. I'd rather see it pre and post. Because you're going to grab the kids from Marshland and everywhere. Not everybody lives in this 3-mile radius. I got to tell you, most of Rollinsford doesn't.
And that would mean that Brittany would have a consistent, she could have a third consistent staff, or you guys could rotate your staff, like 7:30 to 3:30.
Yeah, there's going to need to be 3 in the morning most days anyways. The only day that, week that we could get away with not 3 is...
So if we have our 3 and then the director of
camp.
That's teen camp for at least 3 days.
Yeah.
That would suit us.
Yeah.
Actually.
So you would like,
what if the teen director could not do that? How do we feel about teen people joining?
Personally, I'm okay with teen kids being there if that means a free can be offered. I know that you're pushing for that, and I agree. I think that it would be better for it to be sold as pre and post rather than just one. But it's hard when we already have, for some weeks, having 23 people, and we already need our 3 people for staff. And if we get, like, 6 more of those kids that are already signed up, it comes to a different area.
So I guess my question is does the teen camp director know she has the possibility of starting at 7:30?
Well, and ending at 5:30?
So do we want to go back and revote the pre and post then?
Yeah.
Brittany, are you
okay? I'm just worried about the numbers, but whatever.
Okay. Well, we can go back and...
Okay, so...
I make a motion for pre and post. I'll make a motion for offering pre and post.
Second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so pre and any nays? Alright.
Okay.
What could happen with the team director if this all goes is that she could help on probably on one side of the day. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it wouldn't be.
Just getting back to the original question, do we go to the parents and say there's a possibility?
I would say we're looking at
cutting
back.
If we don't hit a certain number, then we need to.
Yeah. Let's still have our conversation about what weeks people have signed up for.
Mm-hmm.
And then that way that might give us a better idea of
Brittany,
which ones
you
are.
You have admin rights, don't you?
Yeah.
To the sports center, can you get into it?
Mm-hmm.
From there? She would be able to tell us, right?
Yeah, that would be good to know.
And then,
using your laptop.
Yes.
I'll give you the one
that you can. How many do we have for week one? Because we have that problem with week one.
Right there.
Mm. You know what our problem is?
Yeah. Last time I brought up my mother helping with day one, which is Blitz.
Yeah.
She's available to help on Wednesday too, or one of us could go on Wednesday.
I don't know.
Okay.
It would be
I
nice.
Don't know.
To
I think she was just telling
if
me
that's
that
an
we've
issue.
Got a regular
I would say let's eliminate week
sure.
one, because staffing wise we're having issues, and that'll eliminate some headaches. Did you catch that?
I'm sorry.
You guys weren't at the last meeting. The teen camp director cannot make it the first 2 days of teen camp because her other job is ongoing that week.
Mm-hmm.
So if we have to eliminate. Maybe eliminate the first week, and that'll alleviate some headaches for Brittany trying to find coverage for teen camp.
Do you remember? Maybe I just can't remember what it is.
The other thing we've had, and I don't know, who would that have to go through? Would that have to go through the select board to figure out if we wanted to have a sub for her? If a teacher could do that on a volunteer basis, or a parent like myself could do that on a volunteer basis.
I'm thinking that wouldn't be a problem as long as you all, I mean, they all have rental market checks and all
yep.
that, right?
Yeah.
So as long as they're covered under that, I don't think that's a problem.
Do we
have a teacher does? And
yeah, I've been
sure
for the
two.
Do we need to do it through the town so you have the records? Because I've done it through the school.
I'm sorry, do what?
A background check.
As long as you have a background check through the school.
I have done it through the school. So
prove that you have it, that's fine.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, I don't think that's a problem. I'll ask tomorrow, but I don't think it is. Because I mean it doesn't make sense to have to pay another $15 to tell you the same thing.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
you're not a criminal.
But the, like certain entities can't share information with each other. Like, I have to get a separate background check to do Little League, to be on the field, because the school can't share
information. At the same time, I'm sure that would not be a problem.
I know, I've had to get
that
background check downstairs and the school. Downstairs
for what?
Over there when I first applied.
You mean for the rec?
Mm-hmm.
And you were at school
both.
As well?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I had to do
that
both
does
as
not
well.
Make sense to
and
me.
I'm sad at school. Yep.
I'll have to check that out then. That doesn't make any sense to me. We are
I was told
town.
That's what
because
I was confused by when I was
because now if you
I
think about it, any of us are going
to
go get background check. They're not going to have our information by the time.
Can't
pull
it. No.
Right.
I will check that out.
I mean, the basis for that is like, okay, well, the school has cleared them, so why wouldn't you?
Exactly.
I wonder if that had anything to do with the fact that we were associated with Summersworth still.
Well, we still are, technically.
I know, but
yeah.
It all goes to the state
right.
Trooper headquarters, or whatever. I mean, it's done by the state police. I mean, it will
true.
Be done by the same state police that does the town.
Right.
Doesn't make sense.
We should talk to the fuck board about that.
Right now. Why did the state never cause more to do it, right?
And
it's not because we're making money on it, because we're not. It's,
right.
It's the state police is charging.
I logged in, but it sent me to Janessa's name.
Oh, because Janessa's already pulled
in. Yeah, but I
never
typed
in
all my info.
Are you, is she an admin?
No.
Yeah.
I've never logged in. I don't know.
Okay, so I'm going to make a motion on Teen Camp to reduce the number of weeks as necessary to meet threshold. Well, let me think about this for a minute.
Do we need to?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Do you want,
I guess,
take the lead on that?
Yes.
And come to determination by the end of the week?
Yeah. I want a plan, so I don't know how to come up with a plan so that we have a clear, concise decision when we notify parents
by the end of the week.
And what our threshold is. Those are mine, too. Okay, so.
I personally am happy with the 5 or 8 that show and one counselor.
Yeah, because it gives her time too to call the Luciano and
yeah.
Maybe you might get a decent.
Yeah. And you know, there may be weeks none of them signed up for, and then we'll just cancel those weeks.
Right.
So that's fine. But to send them on a wild goose chase
and
now when some registered in March when we
right.
first signed up,
right?
Mm-hmm. I'd hate to do that for them.
What am I looking for?
And do we want to offer
teen? What week's teen?
Tuesday, Thursday.
No.
As it came out of my mouth. So, notify parents by the end of the week about changes to
Annie's schedule.
And give Jody and Kelly a chance to review the numbers this week. Correct? So I'm going to mark
yeah.
that down as a to-do list on
yeah.
and I'll try and get it out tomorrow. So then stay on your radar.
If you click on everything to
my phone,
you'll eventually get it.
That's what I
do.
And first week is,
I'm thinking if the select board asks me about it again, I'm just going to tell them we're working on it, and we'll give them an update as soon as we can.
Talk to the director.
No, she wants to know the first week.
And how many times?
Only the first week? Yeah.
Well, no, we're going to go through
another
director.
Oh, I see.
Give me a paper.
So the first week is June.
25th to the 29th.
Here, I've already got it. This, I'm going to try this. So this is the weeks, 1, 2, but this is first, so just ignore that one.
Okay.
You can put it over here if you want.
Seem like this missing a paper.
Oh, I see. This is wrong. Mm-hmm.
So
this is
like the basic.
Yeah, you have to watch this side.
I just
taught something, or maybe you're interested.
So if you.
You check off which things for each team, and then if they're in one.
And then if they're in most, yeah.
And then you're talking.
But there's like a bit, there's like a major.
Yeah, if you just, are you in the report section?
Is that all I have to do right there?
Participant information and then, you know.
You know what, how about you?
Man, you don't have a mouse?
No. I'm sorry.
I'm going to school.
There's no clicker either.
I did not.
I can't do it without a mouse either.
Oh, gosh.
I did not mean to open a can of worms by asking about team camp.
Yes, you did.
It is worms.
Okay. As long as you don't talk to me about grants, I'm good.
They're all in as a panel, the four that I was working with.
That there are four total?
My, so while they're looking, my other concern is if we eliminate team camp. I've asked for money.
Do you want this one?
No.
For team camp.
Yeah, you want this one?
Or only team camp, or for team camp was part of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Team camp was part of it.
Then I wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah, and then we'll just go down and do.
Okay.
Because, I mean, it's the bigger picture, they're giving you money for
rec program.
And it's gonna be this kind of stuff, I mean, you can explain that if they're requiring you to reply back, I mean, reply back of how you use the money and stuff.
But if you look, if we just look aside, we can see if they're all your team.
You can just list things in general, I wouldn't worry about.
Okay.
Going back and saying you need to remove team camp, I did not do that.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
I'm not going to, because it's still up in the air whether or not it's gonna happen.
I saw two.
I don't think that, as long as there's other things being asked for.
But there's another page as well.
Yeah, okay.
And if they come through with the full amount, then maybe those weeks that the team camps are occurring, we could bolster those weeks with additional.
Unless there's only two for the first week.
So disappointing.
So there's three.
Yeah, it's too bad, because it's a good opportunity, but.
What is your age for team camp?
So, might as well just do check marks, cause I'm gonna, not gonna tell them.
Well, that's, well, that was our whole idea, is that they're not old enough to drive, so most of them are too young to work.
Cause we've got one for June 25th, check mark.
Right.
We could July 23rd, check mark.
So it's like, what is everybody doing, you know?
Four.
But then it goes back to sports.
And then we give August 6th, check mark.
Every sport is loved. Like, we offered T-ball for free and no one showed up. Like, I'm shocked, like, it's free and you didn't show up.
And see, in Marshwood, we have six teams and one coach signed up, and so they put a call out for coaches. And so last minute, like the week before T-ball was supposed to start over there, they're like, we have one coach signed up, parents, we need your help, anybody willing. Coach T-ball, please let us know in the next 48 hours. They got so many parents that didn't know they needed coaches that they ended up drawing from hats, putting the kids.
Week three.
But.
At least they got two responses, you know.
Two check marks for July 9th.
Now, what is we, who are you referring to?
July 16th.
All of the league.
Two check marks.
Rochester, Dover, Summersworth.
You say the numbers, I got what you're saying, cause you have the.
Softball.
July 23rd.
They can't rate travel.
Two, July 23rd.
July 31.
Summersworth numbers are down.
August 6th.
Oh, they might be down to the kicker, this is first year, so.
Yeah.
But, my son is coaching, yeah.
So you said July 30th, one, and then August 6th, one.
One, yep.
Okay.
And then the one I had was weeks 1 through 3, was one more. A paper application that has one.
Oh, 1 through 3?
Yep. And then weeks 5 and 6.
23 and 30.
Can we get all the paper applications that we have in the library?
So we have 4 here.
We can now.
3 here.
Did you read, Caroline's email? Did you read it?
It was a, yeah.
Are you?
I am addressing it with her.
Thank you.
Oh.
No, I'll come over.
I'll come over.
So we have, yeah, at least two every week.
Feliciana.
And it's not including, it's not including your numbers.
Mine.
The two is a really big expense, I mean, that's a lot of money for just two children participating, right?
Bring them on.
What we offered, and I feel bad.
So
So how much?
I know, but you're gonna have the finances to support it.
How much is that weekly tuition?
It doesn't matter whether we have the finances to support it or not. If we don't have the finances.
It's 500 a week.
The town still has to raise all the money, not just some of it. They still have to raise all the money. We allocated $15,000 for teen camp. If we reach 3,000 from the four kids or whatever it is, now the town only has. If we cancel teen camp, the town still has to raise $15,000.
But they're not gonna spend it.
They're gonna find either something to spend it on.
Or.
It doesn't matter, it's still allocated, it's still raised. You still have to charge.
But you don't have to spend it, it goes back to taxation.
But it still gets charged in your taxes.
And it offsets taxes.
And then you're either gonna use it or it goes under general fund. So whether we cancel this program or not, the $15,000 is raised.
Well, we'll agree to disagree.
What do you mean? You still have to raise it.
But you're not spending it. So you may raise it.
You don't know what's coming.
Some alien spent somewhere.
Some pipe may burst. Some.
You might be grateful the money's there. Neutral. I mean, it's supposed to be.
It's supposed to be neutral. I totally agree with you. And that was the whole point.
And so
I don't want
to. Isn't going to make it that way.
No, but what I'm saying is that either way, that was the argument, is that either way, the town's going to have to raise the money. So whether it's from revenue.
Right. Correct. I agree with that.
Or.
That doesn't mean they have to spend it. They would only want to spend what you receive in
so
revenue.
So you're saying that it's going to be raised, and the select board is not going to spend a dime of it and put it back in the general fund?
I'm not saying that. I can't speak to the other two board members.
There you go.
All I can say is that it shouldn't be spent on rec.
No, I know it won't be spent on rec.
No, it should be spent on rec.
It should be spent on rec if it's raised and you receive revenue on it. But if you don't, they're not going to want, I mean, they're going to have to if you keep the program, but they're not going to want to have it come out of taxation and not revenue.
But it does come out of taxation, right?
Yeah. That's what
if you're not raising it, if you don't have enough children that are participating in the program,
right,
and you maintain
the whole part
the program.
Of scaling back. The kids that are coming are going to pay for what they're using.
We hope.
Right.
But if
that's
you have two children, your bus is how much?
Well, that's where the cars come in.
Right.
That's why you call police. Yeah, we'll see what you
yeah.
Do.
I mean, that's
how much of that is going to
be too much money. You're overspending on a trip if you're going to be doing two children to a bus or
I had two lines.
One when there was 20 people, one was when there was 15 people. We're not even.
Okay.
So if it's 500 a week, you can figure on that. 500 a week divided by two.
So it's that $5 you have to.
It's
$250 for your bus, honey.
So we are thinking about scaling back team camp, or are we not?
Let's revisit this at the end of the week.
That's to be determined.
We'll send you an email at the end of the week.
We might be able to figure out some ways. I don't know. We can check costs.
I think I sent it.
The CNN or whatever.
And you're going to notify parents.
Alright, question for you. Has
I'll
anybody
call them
thought about looking up at Fontaine University?
They are capped.
Capped for, I mean, I'm talking about utilization of their buses that they're going to.
They go every day and that's their personal van.
I understand. Who would pay them?
But
if
they have their camp during the summer. That
and
they need their van for.
They have all of their vans are full.
If they only have the one, yeah.
Okay.
They cover that insurance.
Yeah, it's on them. They have
it's their child care insurance that they have for the program.
They're
that they have all year round.
for next Call of Duty?
I was wondering, want to circle back on the scholarship process. Where are we in the scholarship process?
The select board is making a thing.
Making a thingy? What would that mean?
Is it
protocol?
It's in my hands.
Steps. Oh, okay.
I am working on. Do we have anybody who has asked for a scholarship?
Yes.
And
it was in your Facebook.
There were two of them.
I have received nothing personally that says that someone's asking for a scholarship.
It's in the messages when they send us private messages in Facebook.
I'm not getting those. Is that what you were asking me
for?
I'm not getting those.
You're an administrator on that Facebook page.
Okay. All right. So are they asking for it or are they asking, do you offer it?
Both. And then I sent an email. There was one that was a very specific type of scholarship from Community Partners.
I texted it to you.
That I said, well, I will have to forward this to the select board.
It's not opening on my
phone. Okay, that's on the Facebook page.
It was,
it is, and
I snapshot it and sent it to the select board and to the rec committee.
I got that one.
And when was that?
Sometime this week.
Okay, I'll look for it. Okay. So, how many sponsorships have you received funding for?
Three for Camp Raleigh, and one of them is designated Camp Raleigh, from the Legion, the Ladies Auxiliary of the Legion, has been designated as Camp Raleigh. That was their intent. The Police Benevolence Association, we have not reached out to about their intent, but the Ladies Guild of St. Mary's said theirs could be either used for Camp Raleigh or 3 weeks of teen camp.
Did you have that on the list?
The Police Benevolence Scholarship as well?
Of 330, which would cover 8 weeks of Camp Raleigh or 3 weeks of teen camp.
So the one that did Camp Raleigh is $300?
330.
And teen camp? Well, you've got 330, just it's only going to be for three weeks.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
so
then
you have three scholarships at 330.
Yes.
Okay.
And that does not include the $40 registration fee, which was waived in the past, depending on their financial place or whatever. But the 330 does include their bus fees.
Okay, so for both Tina and the, okay. So you have three, so what happens to that money if you didn't have three people getting scholarships? Does
well,
it go back?
Do we have three people?
We never had, well, last year was first year and everybody in the scholarship all got used.
They did, okay.
We had
in the past, we've talked about that too.
Yes.
So what happens if, and I think, I'm not sure if Suzanne, we probably have to go back and ask her about that. I think, or do you remember what she had said about that?
I think it goes back because, you know,
it's designated
as.
Because you can't hold it over right now. You
right.
can't bring it forward to the next year. So
it
if
has
they.
To use our children and
yeah,
okay.
If they're saying that this is definitely for a scholarship and it's not for the program. Then the option is to ask them if they want it back, I would assume, if you didn't have it. So you have, there's a potential. Now, have you ever, last year, you said you used all the money. Did you use it just on three children, or did
we
you
had
use
two
it?
Last year, and we used it on two.
You had two donations, and you used it on two children for the whole.
Mm-hmm. For Camp Raleigh.
For Camp Raleigh. So you never had four students asking for it, and you did receive it.
It was part of the email packet that I gave to the select board that you took.
It's the federal guidelines that my building uses. It's 250% below poverty level.
Say that again, what?
250% below poverty level. And it's a certain dollar amount per family size. So say you're a family of four and you make less than $48,000 and you submit your tax returns to me and it shows that,
mm-hmm.
you qualify.
So what I also asked for is, I asked for a copy of the application for the free and reduced lunches that they do through the school, because I think working on the welfare was really, really way too much information to ask for this particular, especially since we're not funding it, you have funding. So I'm going to look at, see if that, I just got it, let's see what that asks for, you know, kind of, it kind of asks almost the same things, you know, a couple of years of income and, you know, that kind of stuff.
But they don't ask for proof.
Well, we would ask for proof. I'm just using it as a guideline.
Yeah.
You know, just wanted to make sure it wasn't as, welfare's pretty intense, you know, things that they ask for, I don't think necessarily, since we're not even coming up for our own budget, that we could be a little more.
Yeah.
Can it be a Rollinsford resident?
And they can.
And it has to be a Rollinsford resident as well.
And they prove that they still live in Rollinsford.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright.
And not because someone says so.
No.
I liked the idea though, that Caroline offered at one of the select board meetings to make sure that when they hand over their stuff, that they have to sign a paper saying that this is true, and it's a they're signing a paper saying this is all true, and this is a complete picture and not just handing you information and not disclosing, like, the grandparent lives with us and we're not counting that income or whatever.
Right.
So.
Family size is, if mom and dad and the two kids live with grandma and grandpa, that's a family of six.
So we've had the one that came via email that you responded to, right? Sent on to the select board?
For the community partners one, yes, I ordered that on to the select board.
Is that the
director? I want to touch that one.
Is that the director that sent that out to us? The community partners? So I thought we answered that.
No, that
there was something
parents.
Different? Oh, okay.
Because I know Caroline got an inquiry, which was one. Then we came one from a parent. Do you offer financial aid that came to the rec committee?
Has anybody replied to that person?
I thought Jody forwarded on saying this would be a select board thing. And then, is there a Facebook message one too?
There was an email on June 1st that I replied to asking about if there was scholarships available. I said there's not a minimum of week. But there is scholarship programs available for all residents. The select board are creating the guidelines as we speak.
I saw that one.
Yeah,
and
I saw that
one. There's another one. Circle back to the one moving later.
So that person, when you wrote that, Jody never responded back, like, resident and all, blah, blah, blah.
The
right.
One on June 1st?
Right.
I can verify it is a Rollinsford resident.
Okay.
No, that's not the one she's referring to. I know
but I can verify that they're not. So it can be proof.
Oh. I know one of the applicants, that's all I can say.
Sorry, I turned my computer on. Wait till you turn this.
So I think I'm seeing your screenshot there.
Can you wait a date on
that? Yeah, I just saw it. May 29th.
Tuesday. So you're right, Jerry. It was this week.
Yeah, that was that the one about the residents of Dover?
Yes.
Oh, and they get a grant to do a summer program.
Oh, I had replied to that.
Okay. She wanted to use that to pick 2 weeks to come to the program. So that's a teen person, right? That's the teen.
she sends the form to the foundation and then they pay us.
Yep, and I, my reply to them was, as long as we get the payment before the child comes, I'm okay with it.
Okay.
Are you okay with Community Partners patients?
Excuse me?
Are you, oh, is the select board okay with Community Partners patients being at the camp?
Do they need additional support?
Right.
If they're coming from Community Partners, do they need a one-on-one? Can we provide
that?
That's not the question
though.
Was asked. So I only replied to the financial situation.
Okay,
if it's something other than that, then you guys need to reply to that. I'm only answering the financial side of it.
Okay, but you didn't come copy any of us on it?
I replied all.
Let me see.
So that was, that's interesting because I would be unaware of Community Partners being something other than help or income.
Community Partners, we received a check from somebody. I did. For an application, for a registration.
Was it for 2 weeks of teen camp?
Mm-hmm.
Because this is the one I'm talking about. Ice cream.
Oh, yeah.
She didn't
want a smoothie
and then the
I think her question was really, is it okay if you, it's funded by somebody else other than me? It was
right.
Kind of
right.
The interpretation.
That's how I was thinking about it. I wouldn't have thought of that any deeper.
Yep.
But that's because I'm clueless.
Me too at times.
Well, I just know from working, my history is, had a lot of Community Partners clients that use those services after work, and some of them require one-on-one aids, and some require behavioral help or special equipment. I don't know for example.
But when you receive an application from somebody who's part of the group, you determine whether or not they need those are required needs, correct?
I don't know. I don't handle applications. That's why I'm asking.
I don't see an application. I don't, who's that, who does it?
That would be key.
Is this application? If when it comes in, is there any further determination that needs to be made? I know, like, do
we on the form that says,
so
what are your allergies, medications, special requirements, anything I need to know about your child?
Yeah.
So
would they be coming with an aid or anything like that? Or do they have behavioral issues that we need to be aware of? What, like they said, would be on the form.
Mm. So we do get money from, I think I just said that anyways, we do get money for somebody who's been in the program for a long time.
It's safe on the house.
But their check comes from Community Partners on that campus now.
I just don't know.
So I don't know why this would be different, is what I'm saying.
Well, I think she hadn't been part of the program and was asking if it's okay.
Yeah.
And yeah. I said it was okay as long as it was paid before the person came.
So yeah.
Yeah. So that was strictly financial, not any.
Yeah, and to Joey's point, if there's any medical conditions or anything that's associated with the camper, we would know anyways when they fill the application for registration. Okay, so now somebody needs to respond.
Dee is saying that she responded already to the Community Partners woman, as long as they were paid by the time they started camp.
Okay. Sorry, I was reading that.
If that's okay. So, if I get this correct, we have 3 scholarships available. At the moment.
And we haven't had anybody apply.
Well, Caroline sent out an email saying that she had received requests from somebody.
Okay.
So one from Caroline that was forwarded to the select board, right?
So she notified me that what she was going to ask for. So from them. And she's going to hold the form.
And then the one from Community Partners, is that still is that a scholarship or is that taken care of?
Well, it's not a scholarship on our side.
Okay.
They're paying on her behalf, so she's getting a scholarship through somebody else.
Right. And then we had one come via email on June 1st looking for more information.
Facebook. Right.
I saw one come in via email.
The one that Jody answered?
Yeah. And we haven't heard anything back.
Okay. So does she need to email us back?
Who?
Are we waiting on her? Is that what you're asking?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh.
Do you want me to respond to her to get her financials in?
Or it says to check with the select board that they're putting together a process, right? Or
Oh yeah, we don't have the process yet.
I know.
Sorry.
I don't know if we're talking about the same one. Is the initial PC?
Yes.
Then I will contact.
No, but is, did the select board create a process?
I'm working on it.
Okay.
That's me.
Okay.
Yes.
So going forward, Denise, I think that we just, if we have an inquiry into a scholarship fund, should we just forward to you?
Absolutely.
Is that, okay.
Yep.
So that's, let's just make sure we're all on the same page with that.
Yep.
If there's a question regarding scholarship money and the process, goes to
use
Denise.
My selectman's email address,
okay.
And my family doesn't see it.
Okay.
So you use all the same email.
Okay, sounds good.
Do we, what, can you give me that, Denise? I don't know if I have
Denise
it.
Denise.Knowles, help me, Jody, at
Rollinsford.nh.us.
.com.
No,
just
.us.
Okay.
Rollinsford. What is it? Is NH first?
NH.us.
Rollinsford.nh.us, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so.
I get confused with school all the time.
Yes.
No, but I always
K12NH.
Oh, yeah.
I sent you the note.
Okay.
What,
I always
did. You do it like before June 1st? Because I refund the policy June 1st.
I
did
it,
and it doesn't go through.
I don't remember the date.
Yes, it was before June 1st.
Okay.
You're talking about the one.
Yeah, because it would have been before Friday.
And according to our policy, we can refund her.
Okay.
And she's, you have to remind me, is it August 1st she's leaving?
Yes.
Okay. Let me refund her.
And that's easy, so she signed up online. They'll just, I just can just set a refund button.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Oh,
it's
perfect.
Nice and easy.
From here?
Awesome. It's like the easiest one we've done all night.
So, I am seeing that we have 3 available scholarships and 2 people have come forward so far. And
nothing's been given.
Are we going to keep our mouths shut regarding scholarships, or are we going to wait and see if one more comes forward? Or do you want to put out that financial assistance will be available if you meet the requirements?
First, we're going to have a set the requirements. Last year, we sent out an email. Scholarships available, these are the requirements, they must meet, please submit financial packet.
And we, back in March, as a committee, set out what we would like to see. And that was part of the email I, Shane and I, sent to the board and email gave to the board a couple weeks ago. I just don't know if we need to take any further action or if we're just going to stay, because we potentially have another $300 million.
I wouldn't advertise it, because then you're going to get 10 people who are going to respond, and you only have one.
I'm surprised that the 2 people that used it last year haven't responded or haven't registered yet or tried to get.
I mean, the flyers did only go out the other day, so maybe that's part of it.
And
so
we're going around.
Definitely.
Yeah.
And we waited until the very last minute last year for scholarships. So maybe they will come, one of those families will come forward and ask again. So, no further action on scholarships.
Okay, awesome. So I went through everything that I need to talk about right now. Do you have anything that you need from us?
I don't have my laptop. I had nothing else. I don't know, honestly. Not that I can think of right now.
I had something from last meeting that I found out, so I contacted the pool, Dover Pool. So I just kind of threw it out there. How do you want this?
How do you want to pay
it? Right, and I thought, so what would be simpler for us, and maybe it isn't, but I said, would you take 2 payments and buy check? So I said, for the first 4 weeks, we'll send you a check, and then the next 4 weeks, and I said, we'll just need an invoice when we come. And he said that was fine.
Okay.
So, and it's just City of Dover, and I think they're pretty lax, so.
And I can ask him, he's usually there when we're there.
Yeah, so all you need to do is get the invoice. Yeah.
So only 2 checks?
Yeah.
Week 4 and week 8.
two things, supplies.
We have a wish list going right now, I know that.
Where is it?
Can you forward it to us, cause?
There's more getting added to it, but you can send what's on there right now.
Or do you wanna wait until we meet? I know we're meeting in 2 days, so do you want us, can we just forward it to you?
Oh, absolutely, wait, yeah.
We're until Wednesday, it'll be done on Wednesday.
Of course, nothing's gonna be open until then anyway, I have patients on the next couple of days.
So just make a note so that I send it to them.
Cause I'm just in tracking.
And how do we pick up our kids from the pool? Because there's a couple terms that I'm gonna have to pull Zoe from, and you guys are already gonna be at the pool.
We just need to.
Just show up.
That day, that's how we did it.
Just that we've been on level of the pool.
What time are you gonna go to the pool?
I think I have us leaving school at 12:30, so we'll get there like 12:45, times everybody's on the bus.
Okay.
That way they won't change and stuff.
You could probably leave earlier if you want to, but I think.
I think that was one. I think that was one last year, so that's why I had it set up that way. What time is it?
Let me double check with Nick again, but I'm pretty sure that it started at 12:15.
I think the reason we also left at 12:32 was because we were doing lunch before, so.
So they eat at 12.
I mean, your kids eat all day.
Stop that.
I know, stop Zoe, keep feeding Zach.
Oh, Zach is an animal when it comes to eating food, though.
Stop Zoe, stop staying.
Jody, what, you were talking about supplies, and what was your?
You don't get the good Zach, you get the half-done Zach.
I figured that out at the end of the summer.
What was the second thing that you just brought up?
Picking up kids from the pool.
Picking up kids from the pool.
Just let me know when you're dropping them off, what time you're picking them up. Cause we'll have to list sightings.
Oh, we need your phone back. Do you want them, that phone again?
I had, actually, I kinda had a question about that.
Yeah.
With emergency cases last year and having that little phone, I don't know if you want me to go the Facebook route again, or am I calling each parent individually, cause that'll take an hour of our time.
Right, we were gonna, that's something we didn't do, was come up with a communication method.
Your software will now send it out to everybody, just like.
Right, but there were still people that weren't getting the information, cause they weren't checking their emails while they were at work or something, and they came back and they were frustrated.
But you can get texts, it'll send texts too.
Can I text it too?
Yep.
And yes, I'll keep the little phone if I can.
But you can't send texts and stuff from that little phone.
No, you saying I can send texts from the sports engine?
Yes.
That's fine, I'll have my iPad on me all the time.
Okay.
I'm not worried about that.
Okay.
So
even if we do paper registration, we're still in sports engine.
It still goes into the sports engine.
Okay.
Yeah, it does.
Perfect.
And I think
they're having
a human enter it. They're gonna be sent messages. I mean, some people aren't allowed to have their phones in their job.
Right, no, that's part of the parent letter.
Okay.
Right. I think if we just not do, or if you're gonna do it, like, I know you did some through Facebook, but if you do Facebook, you email. Or, like, it's a double.
I tried emailing, and the Gmail last year got a little messed up. So there were emails sent along with the.
Yeah.
Some of them did not go through, cause emails were entered incorrectly.
So we're gonna, going forward, so we're gonna utilize text messages, right?
Sports engine through text messages, yeah.
And I would send them for a couple of, even before camp starts.
Yeah, just to make sure.
So they know how to use it, and like, oh, look, I get text messages.
Can they text back?
No.
I'm sorry, that's the only reason I'm not giving people my number. Otherwise, that would be the easiest, but I do not wanna get texts at 10:00 at night.
I know my parents can email me back. I text you at 10:00.
Okay, this is separate from.
This is an exception.
Other 62 parents.
So are you thinking about using a combination, or was that suggested of the combination of Facebook and?
Yeah, I plan on making another secret Facebook group with this year's parents for pictures and stuff. And then using, it was secret last year.
Yeah.
Secret.
I can see that. She did the same thing. I just like the word secret.
What about creating a, I know addresses without creating an email, a mass email blank carbon copy to go from your rec directors?
I know how to do that now. Tom's helping me with that. I didn't know how to do that last year. I tried and I didn't set it up correctly, but I have that issue.
So then you could just have all of them in there, and then you could just have a group and a group conversation. And if there's an emergency, you can send out an email to, like a, from the rec director.
Yep.
Okay. I'm so glad Denise can make it, but the town hall staff, and I know Denise has asked when I've been at the select board meetings presenting grants, if at by any chance can we move these meetings to a weeknight so we can have her presence more often?
Yeah, when I mean, I'm fine. The only nights I can't do it are Mondays.
Me and Callie are going, it's softball season.
Maybe at 9 p.m. we can start.
Well, it's just like every weekend I'm going to be gone. Like, so.
Well, summer's coming along.
Well, yeah, we're going to be.
Well, we didn't meet very much during the summer last year. I mean, it was
like
really.
That actually went through. at least that I know.
One meeting?
Yeah. I remember.
Yeah, I don't think we met very much during the summertime.
Because you saw each other so frequent anyways, like in the mornings.
Right. We were all hanging out there.
Having those side conversations. it doesn't bother me that as long as we can come up with a common date. Because
you're missing a lot of people tonight, aren't you?
Yeah, and we just got an email from one of them, moments, I think, or meeting, saying that she was just wouldn't make it. So, and if we're going to continue to meet on Sunday nights, I would appreciate every once in a while either one of the chairs coming to a meeting of the select board to give them an update, because when I'm presenting grants, I felt a little caught off guard answering questions about teen camp, but I wasn't sure because I didn't have the numbers.
You know, the thing, Mondays are difficult to make, so I've got classes Mondays.
So, I just wanted
I would love to.
So, that was that. The town hall staff, like I put my email, has been fielding lots of questions about I created a list up there on the wall next to the applications that has our email address. Do we need to give them any more contact information?
It has her email and phone number on the website and on the paper.
In the paper packet. But I guess they have, the application say due by May 31st, so they have people here on Thursday night. I have to get this in today. I need immediate answers. How can I get hold of somebody who can answer this?
It's from that paperwork that you're holding.
Oh, I feel it's some very interesting questions. Now. I mean, I know the two, I really just want to say read the paperwork, but.
If you want to field the silly, obvious questions, they can go to the director email. I don't mind answering, like, camp questions. Mm-hmm.
That was confusing. Some people thought that they had to get their stuff in by May 31st, and I think that was confusing for some people.
So,
that's confusing.
I did make a sign, and it's up on the box now, that says registration remains open until June 15th.
Yeah.
So if people come in.
But online is easier.
Yeah.
But she's helping the one that's being asked the questions who knows none of the answers. So, both is the best way.
So I put up a sheet, the town clerk and whoever's in the office can say, go take a tab off of that, contact them. So that's, and then it goes to all of us. And I think you're on.
I don't see the emails that you guys are replying. The original ones, I don't see them.
So you see our replies?
I see your replies, but I don't see the original ones.
Interesting.
Because I'm like, what is Jody replying to right now? And my phone blew up the other day when you answered a bunch of emails all at once. I had no idea what they were. And I'm constantly checking my email.
So check to make sure that you're on the rec. You should have been on anything that goes to rec committee should go to you.
Right. And if you're getting the reply, why wouldn't
just
you get the original?
What is the
bizarre
thing?
What is it?
Right now, it's supposed to be my
That's a lot.
Our,
the rec committee.
I can
see.
I know, but what
yeah.
is it?
REC.
What is it? REC.
DIR.
DIR.
I can
so okay. Make sure it's on the
I can give well everybody
it's
as
them.
Sort of
yeah.
Okay.
About
okay.
The PTO.
Sure it's on the rec.
Go. Well, no, I don't really have much to update except I sent out another.
Because if it does
okay.
that, it's easier for me to answer.
Yep.
Kelly's
going
to
make sure.
Well, I don't really have much to update because I sent out another message to PTO and got nothing in response. So, I
don't
know.
Did they go out at school?
I don't know what the deal is.
Did they go out at school?
They've already been told it finished
yeah,
on
they've been
Tuesday.
Sending cards
kids. Oh, so you don't they
wait so they've chosen the winners right?
they've chosen
so
the winners
all that. Okay.
But they haven't announced it unless you're in the school
right.
like from what I understand or went
they
home
even announce it. They just slide it in your box and you give it to the kids in your classroom
so nobody knew who was winning on what days
mm-hmm.
and Kristen Palenka even challenged the community if you buy a calendar and it's announced that you want or I want I will trade with you for your day. I will give you my calendar. But it was never announced. It just went home with different kids who had sold the calendars. So, and then we have not gotten a response from the PTO on how much we've raised through selling the calendars and what the donation is that we're looking to receive from them.
And I sent, yeah. So I got nothing. I got nothing.
I only know one member on the PTO. Is there somebody else?
Yeah, I know them all. I can give it to you in 3 months.
Yeah, why don't you do that?
I sent that.
If I go to the school tomorrow, is somebody that I could talk to?
So this, my last text was May 24th. And I said, wondering if you have money total for sales of calendars and if you are posting winners anywhere on Facebook PTO page, question mark?
So.
Nothing.
Now it does done. Sorry.
But I did, I think I told you weren't here the last, I did ask Caroline at the school what she thought the total was, and she thought the total was approximately $1,600, so it was a pretty, yes.
One more,
each or dividing
I think that was the total sales.
Okay.
Yeah.
Caroline,
yep.
So I'm going to go talk to her.
I shared
Caroline about
Team Camp on Facebook.
I've
already had 7 shares,
so these two
and
I've already had
somebody
messaged me and asked me. Well, geez, where have you been this whole summer?
Where'd
you start? He's more
popular. But yeah, so somebody's already messaged me asking me about camp, and she seems interested, so I sent her a little blurb, and then
send them to the John Rollinsford website, Camp Rollins.
Okay.
You can register online.
If you go to the
website.
Do you know how many times I've written that out?
Okay.
I say
for it.
Sometimes twice. I think that was an email. We didn't go
Oh, the Facebook page?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, it's been brought to my attention that we're not selling the program very well if the town hall staff is not able to answer our programs and we're not making it look successful and stuff. So I just want to put it out there that...
Wait. It was my understanding that the town hall didn't want to do or didn't... That was my understanding. So that...
Everything that we've done, including the financials, we've tried to keep the town hall out of it. So
yes,
and
because that's what I thought they wanted from us. So this is a very different.
Well, no, that's what I got from them too. But a comment was made to me in passing that by having the applications here and not and the staff not being able to answer questions has caused a lot of confusion and frustration for parents and may not be the best.
Don't go there.
Things. We may not be putting our best foot forward by having it.
Walking into town hall.
I walked into town hall and I got bombarded here.
So we purposely, so in the packets, we purposely try to steer people away
from town hall.
Yes.
And for that reason.
She should have.
So, but maybe going forward, whether it be finishing up this year or next year, we can just speak with the town hall and be, just get more aligned with them.
I see no reason why you can't have applications here on a side table. If they don't want to hand it to them, you know, side table, I will talk to the board as well on this. This is a town sponsored and it needs to be straight across.
So.
And Caroline has been totally okay with the taking in the money and all of that. It's not Caroline, correct? Yeah, didn't think so. Okay, well, I'll work on that.
So when I was handing out more flyers to bring in money, I got a parent that was addressed in my email who was very upset that they had felt like communication dropped off. Dee has since addressed it, but my question is if somebody bumps into me and has a complaint or a concern, am I referring them to the two of you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, ultimately, I mean, it's okay to listen to them, for sure. So they can hear their grievances, but yeah, definitely send them to the
okay.
Yeah, fix whatever it is.
Well, that's not my area. Here's Dee's email.
Okay. It was also suggested by the town hall staff that there used to be an ice cream social and a award ceremony at the end of the school year, and they wanted to know, why isn't the rec sitting out there with application forms to bring in parents who are attending school events?
Wait, was there
an there wasn't
social?
An ice cream social.
There wasn't an ice cream social. They didn't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be in April. It was supposed to be in April, then the PTO moved it to May, the weekend before Memorial Day, and then they never did.
Then they
the
never
kid.
Had it.
Yeah.
So, well.
So, I was asked, why aren't you guys sitting at school for their awards ceremony?
I don't like this. I'm sorry. I'm just going to be honest. I mean, I don't like that. I don't want to be disjointed with every other committee or town body, or I don't want to be.
If they want
to like
that, they should come to our meetings. If they want to be part of the rec committee, be part of the rec committee.
Yeah.
So it was just suggested that maybe we look into school events and see if we could be there too. To
just tell them that
you
can
don't
do whatever you can do and just
this
don't
is
bicker with them.
This is a town function, not a school
right.
function. Do you know how many kids are coming from out of town and out of our school?
It's like
yeah.
almost 50-50.
Like, this is not just grade school.
Yeah.
You're not reaching just grade school. You are reaching the town. So.
And it's like you, who has kids in town,
but
yes.
not in the school.
But not in the school. We
yes.
wouldn't reach
I'm
you
in
unless
every sport. I'm in everything. But my kids are not in the grade school. Her kids are not in the grade school.
Half of them aren't
in the grade
school. Or we have the kids in the community who are homeschooled that we're not reaching by just focusing on the
exactly.
school.
Exactly. If they have, if the town, other town members have ideas, we'd be happy to take them in as
right.
That's
committee
a perfect
members.
Response. We appreciate your ideas. Don't be under back and forth at all. I mean, if an ice cream social is a great to kick it off, let's talk about that next year. You missed it this year. I mean, but I think that's a great idea to maybe a month before kickoff.
And we
maybe
were at the town
meeting.
And we were at the ice cream social last year. It just didn't
but
happen this year.
But
it's not even
you know,
like a bad idea.
It's a way of making money, too. You know,
right.
So we should put it on the agenda for next year. But, you know, I mean, everyone has a lot of ideas. Nobody wants to step up to the plate. Let's just leave it at that.
Yeah.
So I was out canvassing this week to bring in more money.
You're in the role studio.
Some leather out of Maine wants to come in and do a leather working project or teach the kids about leather working.
Are parents going to be okay with that?
Are there sharp items to use?
He said he'll come in and he'll give a talk to the kids. They don't have to use the little.
Just like the fifth, sixth graders.
And I told him to email us and we would put him in contact with her.
I think the little ones might be a little freaked out.
And that she
no.
could
no.
schedule a time with him with a specific group, like fifth, sixth graders.
So does she have the information?
He has not emailed
her. Once you get the information, just send
it
to her, and then she can.
put that
she
in.
She can make that determination.
Yeah.
That's what she wants to do.
At our last meeting, a lot of people said, oh, I have a contact for this, I have a contact for that. Somebody had a contact at the children's museum, somebody had a contact at the shipyard. I created a list for Brittany and sent it over to her of the contact list. And then I have a list for all the grants, and I can send it over to you for the contacts for that. But if people have contacts, can we put it in this spreadsheet so it's in one place, pass on year to year, so that way we're not
constantly. Even like for a student, I mean, just a whole bunch of stuff that you put in there. That's
so,
a great idea.
If all the grants come in, I think we get, we have between like 1,600 to 2,400 in grants for doodlebugs. So do we want to do more than 1 week program? Do we want to have them come in for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, if we can get all the money in?
Is it only to go on the doodlebugs?
Well, one of the grants we weren't sure we could apply for, so it, last minute they said, oh yeah, send it to us, but we're not sure we're going to fund you because we're brand new in Dover. So I asked, in case the grants don't come in, can we have $800? But if all of them come in, we'll have between... And I said,
well, when will we know that?
All going to Doodlebugs, or am I still contacting Chris and waiting for that reply? Like,
did you contact him? Is he available?
I'm waiting for an email. I'm waiting for a reply.
There is.
If he's a bit, I mean, he might not be
right,
available.
He was booked up at the
so I think,
year,
to Brittany's point, she needs to know what we can spend the money on.
Yeah.
I have a list I will forward to you. Of all of the people I put into the grants.
Oh, well, that would be a good idea.
Yeah. Can you do that too?
But
yeah.
we problem with that is you can't plan something until we hear from the grant.
Yeah. But you could say pending funding approval.
But you have to have alternative stuff.
Yeah.
Your writer friend, storytelling friend.
Yeah.
She's still available, and could I have that contact?
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, he's definitely available.
Okay. So I was thinking first week.
I went to
yeah.
Cumberland Farms.
I'll send it to
you. Main office in Dover. Do we want to ask them for a donation of goods or a donation of money?
You don't go through Dover, you know that, right? You have to go through Massachusetts.
Yes, they sent me an online form that I have to fill out.
It's
okay.
Through Massachusetts,
yeah.
Through the office.
But we can request snack foods from them, like Cumberland Farms, chips and stuff like that.
Oh my god, what about the pepperoni and cheese thing? I love those.
Or I was thinking about asking for like $250, then Brittany could bring in her aquatic show for Mermaid Week or whatever. And that, if they weren't willing to give us that, then we could go with.
Do you have to choose one? You do.
Yeah, the application.
I know, it sounds like we have a lot of grant money possibilities.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go for some goods.
But I thought we decided last meeting that we weren't sure what we were going to do for snacks because of different allergies and all sorts of different things.
Very limited, please.
Also, just maybe choose. I wasn't here for that, but maybe like 4 or 5
free
snacks.
Yeah.
Okay.
We just, I felt
nothing
like humongous because there was a bunch of stuff that
we
none
threw
of the kids
out
ate.
Last year.
I felt like we wasted
a lot of stuff.
Well, you know what? I feel like you guys have the best idea of what sold,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, so just pick like a small handful of items that you want to keep.
Right.
That were the best sellers. I mean,
even honestly, if there's a chance where like just Brittany and I could, like a couple of days before camp, run to the store and maybe get like money back for it or something. I don't know how it works, but.
But even, I can go to Hanford and get a
gift card.
$50 gift card. I can go to Target and
mm-hmm.
get a $50 gift card. And Walmart, we can, so those two usually get $50 gift cards. And so you can go to Hanford and buy $50 worth of freeze pops or $50 worth of snacks.
But Cumberland might do that as well for you.
Mm-hmm.
He might give you a gift card versus
cash
or whatever.
Right.
So
then
you can go down there and get, even if it's just water, you're buying their
water. We bought water last year, tons of water, and it didn't sell. We ended up with 5 or 6 cases at the end of the summer.
Mm-hmm.
And Genado's Market, I left something there, and last year they gave us a $25 gift card out of Dover.
Mm-hmm.
So,
gift card would be awesome.
Yeah, and
so
then we can just go when we need it.
When we need it, yeah.
And Thirsty Moose out of Dover has given us a $25 gift card.
Beer for everybody.
That's for the council.
After the day is over, yes.
Except for like two counselors.
It's
for
just me
21.
And Katie.
Well, there you go.
That's a good thing.
But we can ask Walmart for up to $250 from the local Walmart store. But we need to ask, we need to make a decision and request the select board sign an official letter if we want to go through Walmart.
Yeah.
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 Say yes.
Yes, because we need sprinklers that they may break every week. And homeless
every week.
And
well, it was the funky one that they kept breaking.
I'm assuming they're going to go through eight sprinklers. Two hoses.
Yeah.
And if anybody has any other contact information for people who might donate, we had two or three other people who donated last year who have not yet come back to us. And a sign for donors, because if we get Cumberland Farms and stuff, and C&J raised this about how do we show our appreciation and our sponsors.
Where are we going to do signs? Where are we going to do like a Vistaprint
like
sign or something?
Right?
I had done that when, with a family day. And just hung it over by the fire station in that big lot and thanked all of the people. You know, I'm confused by sometimes when they're asking about how we're going to show that, you know, because putting it in Foster's like letter to the editor and stuff, to me that just opens it up for everyone to see, oh, they give, we'll go to them. And I would think that they wouldn't want it that way.
Right.
And so, you know, I think a banner in our town is fine. And we can get a really pretty reasonable and Vistaprint statement. It's very, very reasonable. Because it's not something you would use year-round, every year because it changes. And staples are very reasonable.
Oh, really?
And only a week's notice, too. You know, if you do, then they do it right there.
And I was going to check with the people that do our shirts and see if they can do it. They're here in town.
And the other thing is that you can just do a press release with the back of their shirts, like Camp Raleigh, because they're always looking for something nice to put in the paper. And if you do the back of the shirts, because they want their back of the shirts so shown, you can have the kids all stand there with the back of the shirts and with the ones that are being photographed. And, you know, camp is open in Rollinsburg.
Just C&J.
Oh,
okay,
but
that's just C&J. Yeah.
Because
yeah.
They
that's what they wanted it. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Okay.
And they wanted a picture of what's on the back, and if we can put that in the paper, great.
Yeah.
So C&J was concerned that they were not getting return on theirs, and then Cumberland Farms wants to know how we're going to promote and advertise that they donated to us, and so forth. And so, Brittany, this is maybe something for you. Can we check? Maybe we don't need to check with the school. Can we put something on the school fence with zip ties or something?
I was able to for family day.
Just have it there all summer long. A suggestion from Suzanne came from, to have a smaller one that we can take on field trips that says Camp Raleigh is here, sponsored by, or whatever. And then wherever we go, they can just toss this small banner on the bus. And then you can.
I don't like the banner at the park.
Well, it's just something to be left behind.
It's something to be behind.
That's
and
another thing we can stress about. It's either that or a
kid.
You
yeah. yeah. Or it's like someone's gonna roll up in it on the bus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That or wipe his sweaty head all over.
Oh yeah. Just
also
roll.
With Family Day, I put a letter in the annual report every year, and I list all of our sponsors in that as well. So whoever gets the annual report and reads it will see it.
Then my other question was, what about putting it on our Facebook page or our website?
Yeah.
That once we come up with an image, I can forward it to you guys.
As soon as you get the correct C&J thing. We'll just blaster that. I'll be out there again.
Okay.
thanks again to see you today. We can just constantly keep pushing that once a week or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it scrolls across.
And should I send it to like Kia? Like if we're doing a press release for the newspaper, could it go out on through the town, or is that through the town email? Like Camp Raleigh would like to thank like C&J for sponsoring us, and then it goes out to the whole town?
Well, they did it when I did like the town Rawls put out for Family Day. I listed all the people who sponsored it, and it went out on the town website.
Okay. But I know you guys said something about the logo wasn't right, so once you get
we got the correct one,
send
and
it to me. Yeah.
I will get it over to you. It's in my email.
But you're going to do all, not just C&J, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
But right now,
I mean, you could do one with just him as the sponsor of the shirts and the back of the shirts and stuff, but you should, if you're going to thank, you need to thank all of them.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
Right.
So, yes. And then Dick's sent us these coupons.
Right.
I got called down to the town hall. They gave us community coupons, and they're probably going to go home with you.
Is this a cover?
That's a cover.
We all need bats.
Can
I
use this
next
week?
These.
Wait, is this the whole coupon book? Or is it just one? You sell one.
No, these are free of charge from Dick's as a thank you. And I need to contact Dick's to find out if this is their donation to the summer camp, because we did apply to them, or if they just.
This should go as like first day of camp.
Yeah, that's what was suggested.
Like, right.
Oh, like when the parents
show up. Yeah.
When you give them their shirts, they, each parent should get one of these. So you could like wrap the shirts around one of these so that each kid gets a flyer for Dick's.
That's nice, actually. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
If it's not the actual fundraiser.
Yes,
whatever.
Jody, can I help you?
I should weigh my shirt.
Speaking
of. Ready.
Here,
you
need to get one. I got
softball.
Yeah,
grab me.
Did you snap them?
No.
I promise I'll sign up again.
You can come on the
29th.
You too.
That's all
I'm saying.
Oh, you. I don't get what if I don't
sign up again. I'll get another
shirt.
I got it right here.
Finally.
No. Somebody had an idea last year, and I cannot remember who, so I saw. I apologize for not giving them credit, but having the first day, like the Friday before or the Saturday before, so they get to meet the counselors, and they get to meet the kids, and they get to hand out the shirts, so it's not crazy that first day, and then that could be like an ice cream social kind of thing. It doesn't even have to be ice cream. Popsicles. I don't care. But just the idea, so that first morning is in chaos. Someone's like, oh, it would have been nice if we could have met the counselors beforehand and I didn't have to rush off to work. So, either.
You can say no. I'm just, I couldn't.
Like
well,
a Saturday?
No,
Saturday,
the
Saturday.
That's what we're going to do, then if I want to be available for it. So.
When are you back?
Are you here Friday?
Even Saturday.
Give me a. I'll let you know.
You don't give us. Yeah, you don't need to give us any. But
I was just
you guys
saying,
like
I was
thought.
Saturday, yeah.
Like they did, well, they did that for, you know, classrooms too. Like, when did they usually do that? Three days before the school started? They always had that. And they give a very specific time. So, all day.
Oh, yeah. It would be like
a
5:30 to 6:30 kind of thing.
And 1 hour. Good.
Yeah.
That's
a good idea. Come grab your popsicles and your t-shirts for your camp starting next week. Come meet your counselors. Have any questions we can answer for you? Put money on your account.
Oh, yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I think.
And just let us know the day.
The money on the account.
The access code is always different. Because we're
having to borrow.
Can they borrow?
Is that what that's also okay. Not a thing. Nobody can borrow.
So that's a good idea. So you and can you and Janessa just let us know if that's something you're gonna do?
Yeah.
That would be really great.
And
we
I
can put it on Facebook and all that.
I would also encourage you to make sure you have the shirts ahead of time and ready to go.
Yep.
And it might depend on when the shirts are ready.
When did they say they'd be ready?
We had to, we postponed it a couple of days from when we were supposed to put it in so we could have a committee meeting to work out all the numbers and stuff. So we're looking at mid-June right now.
The next week I have.
Yeah, that'll start.
25th.
Is this the same thing we're talking about?
I need a.
Yes.
Are those going in August?
Wasn't there something wrong with this?
That is the updated number.
She didn't have the swish before.
What about the old shirts that we have? What are we doing with those?
And do they want it green?
There's.
I thought they were blue.
I thought we would still call it good because they're basically the same. There's just a slight difference in the logo.
Yeah, it's fine. It's would be my opinion, actually.
Yeah, old shirt, I don't care.
Yeah, I don't care either.
When can I get those extra shirts from you?
They're in the car.
Oh, okay, that's part of the box now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, and they'll have it.
Wait, are these shirts?
Yeah, they're all in the car.
Are these the shirts that are CJ ones or are these one?
No, these ones are. CJ is blue and white. Team Skinny White with a black logo. So we can tie dye them.
And I was thinking if we could get some money from Walmart with the old one, your tie dye suits.
Oh, you don't have to come and do it. No, it's no, because I'm going to go to Farmington, so you don't have to come.
Why?
Because my mom has a yard and I do not.
I have a yard.
Okay.
And a pool.
Yeah, I know. I have a convenience store, okay?
Do we have anything else that we need to talk about?
Brittany, do you have anything?
In the fall, when we start talking about budgets, I would like to take the select board suggestion of hiring a part-time year-round rec director.
That was something that we've been talking about, was I just quit my other part-time job to finish all of this stuff before camp happens.
Oh,
I'm not even getting paid for camp until July.
Yeah.
And I have loans and I have rent and this month is going to be ridiculous.
No, you have budgeted hours for pre-camp.
But I like the paychecks don't start until July.
What you're saying is that you've been working a lot.
If you
yeah,
put in
like
hours
I've just
now,
been doing
you're not
stuff.
She's doing it
right,
kind of similar.
Yes, because I want the program to.
I'm overstepping my mouth right now. But I'm assuming that you're putting in the hours.
I'm not logging it or anything.
But log it, and I'm assuming the select board will sign it because you have allotted hours for pre-K. So.
If that is true, probably, yes.
Yes.
I don't know that answer.
Yeah.
But yes.
How would I log it?
Just have to turn it into a
just like you did last year. Said
Caroline?
Yeah.
If it's,
just like you did last year.
If it's been budgeted for pre-work,
yeah,
then
yeah.
You should be able to.
How many, do you remember how much we did for that?
I can look that.
It's days though.
Do you have to get somebody to do that from somebody at
See,
this
that's
table?
What I was wondering.
Did you
I
last
would,
year?
I didn't
know it was a thing last year.
Her boss
was
selected. So there you go.
Her
so
boss
was
selected.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then she signs everybody else's time card and turns it into the select board, and then the select board signs those. Is it still Mike sign all the time cards still?
He sends all the checks. I don't know if he sends the checks.
Yeah, he uses it. Somebody does.
Yep.
Good to know.
Yeah.
All right, we have to figure out a next meeting date.
Yes.
Oh God,
we do.
And you want it midweek.
The budget you were just talking about. Do I have that? Or can I have that?
What were we about her
yeah.
pre-camp?
Yep.
Jody said that she had it.
Oh, okay.
What? 3 hours. How many hours do we have for?
I'll look it up.
Can you send that to me as well?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I don't remember that.
It's in a spreadsheet at work somewhere.
Okay.
All right, so do we want to meet before? Yes,
tomorrow I'm not working.
I would think so.
I would hope between June 15th and June 25th.
That
we between
meet.
The end of registration and the start of camp.
Yes, we should
I can do it on the 24th, but I'm gone. Otherwise, before that, like the week before.
I thought we were doing a midweek.
Oh, right.
I cannot schedule anything because I don't know. We have one.
I can do the 14th.
We want to do, could you do the following week? Didn't we want to do the following week? Denise, what's a good night for you?
Anything but Wednesday, on Monday.
Anything but Monday.
Yeah,
what do you do on Mondays?
Slackboard.
Oh,
nice outing.
You can leave it.
As long as
these aren't as long as yours is.
We can do,
as
long as there's two of them there, we can do it here.
I'm not sure they'd like that.
What if we do the 14th? That's the night before registration closes, and we'll have a
day of the week is
Thursday. There are Marshwood Middle School awards that night.
Yeah, that week's going to be tough.
Yes, which I would assume your child would be getting an award.
I have no idea. I didn't even know what was happening.
It's an academic thing. If he's gotten all A's and B's all year, he will be acknowledged.
He's gotten a few C's, but that's
okay.
Okay. Otherwise, he's doing
Yes. He is.
I have no complaints.
How about, let me just throw, how about the 19th? It's a Tuesday.
As long as you can be here, I can't be here. I'm gone the 16th through the 23rd.
You did that last year.
Yeah, it's the same week. I'm just gone that week. Yeah, sorry.
I can do it.
How rude.
It's
my birthday.
I know.
Oh, well, we'll bring up a beer and a piece of cake for you. I can be here. So maybe you and I can meet before you leave.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
Would that be good?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. So is everybody okay with the 19th then?
Rec meeting at 7?
Rec meeting at 7? Yes? Does that work?
Yeah, that's good.
Does it have to be 7? It can be 6:30?
I can do 6:30.
I think I can do 6:30.
Okay.
I have
can
nothing
half
like
hour
that
before.
So
7
see.
Is okay. I mean, it's just
6:30.
You know, we just really talk until 9, Denise. So it really doesn't matter when we start, but we can't leave until after 9. All right, so rec meeting the 19th. Dee, maybe you and I can meet on the Father's Day. Wouldn't probably be a good day to meet, but
mm-hmm.
Every day is Father's Day in my house.
No, I can do it other week, any time of the week of the, well, we can't the 14th, but we'll, you and I will.
We'll
okay,
have to, we'll touch base, okay.
Yeah, it's next plan, day number 4, I have to make it that far.
What are we going to build on?
Do all the teams do
I've been waiting for dates from you.
He's a Mayhew, right?
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Maybe,
that.
I don't either. Because we didn't, I don't
I'll
recall
take,
doing it last year.
I'll take a break in between.
The last year.
Was that?
So is the meeting adjourned?
So
is there anything else?
Any
sorry.
Other notes of business are we good here?
No, good.
All right. 9:05.
Can I say
yes.
Yes.
Motion
so
to adjourn.
Yeah.
Second?
Okay.
Every? All?
Yes.
Yes. All in favor?
Yes.
Go home.